throughout this movie, I had this one thought in my mind. Where were all the banana jokes with the Minions? I mean, maybe there was a banana joke here and there throughout the movie, but certainly not prevalent throughout. Just where? By the way, why are these bananas green? They aren't yellow. I just killed the joke. What is up, everybody? Random Random Man here, bringing you my review for Despicable Me 3. Now, the plot basically follows Gru, voiced by Steve Carell, who teams up with his long-lost twin brother, Drew, also voiced by Steve Carell, to take down a new enemy, Balthazar Brat, voiced by Trey Parker, who is a child actor from the 1980s who grows up to be a villain. Going into this movie, I was actually looking forward to it. I, as a whole, enjoyed the Despicable Me franchise. I really enjoyed the first one. I also really enjoyed the second one, which to me is my personal favorite of the series, and even the spin-off prequel Minions I liked. With the voice acting, those who reprise their roles from previous films do as good of jobs as they've done before. Steve Carell voicing Gru with that ridiculously exaggerated accent, also applying it for Drew as well, is always nice to hear. Kristen Wiig also returns from the second movie as Gru's wife, Lucy. I really like her. Miranda Cosgrove and Dana Gier reprise their roles as Margot and Edith, respectively, two of Gru's daughters. We also have Julie Andrews coming back to voice Gru and Drew's mom. And Steve Coogan makes a brief appearance as the director of the AVL for which Gru and Lucy work for. Jenny Slate even has a super duper minor role as the employee who replaces Coogan's director character and ends up firing Gru and Lucy for not getting Balthazar Brat, which brings us to him, voiced by Trey Parker of South Park fame. Now, at first, I was a little put off by him being the voice for this new villain. As eccentrically zany as this villain is, it kind of felt like at times that he was just voicing another South Park character or anything else that he's done in the past. But with the personality that his character does exude, with him brimming the 1980s everywhere, what with wearing outfits with shoulder pads, always listening to hits from that decade, just with all that made me think the voice acting here still delivered. With the story and writing overall, this movie uses the basic and tired trope of having a long-lost sibling come into the lives of a character. This story shares a couple of subplots with itself. Lucy trying to be a mom to Gru's three daughters. The subplot with the youngest daughter, Agnes, now voiced by Nev Sherrill, trying to find a unicorn. And then there's even another subplot with the Minions as they go to prison. Of all of these story threads, the one that was the most well-realized was the main one with Gru and Drew getting along with each other. What with Drew trying to be as good of a villain as Gru is, and the other subplots end up faltering. Even Margot, the oldest daughter of Gru and Lucy, has a retreaded subplot from Despicable Me 2 involving a boy, but that is taken care of really, really fast when Lucy gets involved again with her trying to be a mom. So the story and character utilization here was more of whatever fits your taste or whatever kept you the most interested here, as when they all culminated by the end, I thought it wrapped up nicely. Plus, for me on a personal level, I liked the main storyline of Gru and Drew getting together, trying to take down Balthazar Brat, as it reminded me of how I got along with my own brother. What with our own quarrels, what with us getting along in the end either way, just stuff like that was able to still shine through, even if this wasn't as developed as the other familial themes in the previous Despicable Me films. Plus, this movie has humor involving having a sibling, among other jokes in this film, which made me consistently chuckle throughout. I didn't laugh out loud that much to my recollection in this movie, but this film's oddball nature at its core is gonna be enough for audiences of all ages to really get into it. That leads me to the animation, which I find illuminating overall, pun intended, and I also see how much Illumination Entertainment has grown since the first Despicable Me film back in 2010. The animation has gotten a lot more tight, it still remains colorful, very vibrant, zany, just like the characters themselves, very visually appealing to watch, and again, that goes along with the humor being coupled in with it. Like with the Minions, they are used sparingly throughout this movie, it's not like they're the main focus like they were in their prequel spinoff 2 years ago, but I do personally enjoy the Minions because I do get their appeal. They hardly ever speak English. In fact, Pierre Coffin voices the Minions with many languages that span from like French, Spanish, Italian, what have you. It appeals to a wide demographic from a lot of people around the world, and the Minions also remind me of slapstick comedy of old from either the silent era or just classic movies in general, which is why I enjoyed them in their small bursts here. The movie does also have a nice score, co-composed by Pharrell Williams. I mean, there's not a catchy song in here, just like Happy from Despicable Me 2, but I was more interested in some of the short instances of 1980s music that was used throughout, from Balthazar Brat as he listens to him on a Walkman. Clocking in at about 90 minutes, I thought Despicable Me 3 was well timed overall. I feel that not too many animated movies should even clock in at more than an hour and a half, so that was nice to see as this film mainly gets the job done, as I feel that it is an enjoyable time. Comparing this film to the other movies in the series, it is not my favorite. I think it is the weakest of the main trilogy. I prefer the first and second film over this third entry, but I did enjoy Despicable Me 3 more than the Minions movie. If you are not a fan of this franchise, this film is not gonna turn you over into a fan, really, even if the Minions are not as prevalent in their screen time as they were in their own film. But if you are a fan of the series like me, I recommend it. My final verdict for Despicable Me 3 is 3.5 out of 5 stars. Thank you all, as always, for watching. Be sure to like this video, comment on what you thought of Despicable Me 3, subscribe to my channel for more, and I'll catch you on the next movie review.